Dear students, welcome to this session of design of PDA. On the last session, I had given you certain problems to solve at home. These problems were corresponding to the language of all words W which are formed from the alphabet A and B, where number of A's were greater than number of B's. So this was the first problem. And the second problem was where the number of A's were less than the number of B's. And the third problem was where number of A's and number of B's were not equal. So now one by one, I will be discussing their solutions. Now let us discuss the solution of our first problem. That is when L is equal to all words W over A and B, such that number of A's in our word W is greater than number of B's in our word W. Okay, so number of A's are greater than number of B's. Before going to its solution, I will first review the solution which we have discussed on the last session, where number of A's were equal to the number of B's. Okay, so for that solution, what we have done, in the same state, we were pushing when we were getting the similar symbols and we were popping when we were getting the different symbols. Okay, so the solution was in Q0 state when we get the first letter either A or B, we were pushing it. So these two transitions are pushing the first letter. So when we are getting A in the condition Z0, we are pushing it. When we are getting B in the condition Z0, then also we are pushing it. And then when either A or B is on the top of the pushdown store, as first letter has been pushed. Okay. So if A is on the top and we are getting the similar input, then we are pushing it. Okay. Similarly, if B is on the top and we are getting the similar input, we are pushing it. So by these two transitions, we are pushing when our PDA stop and inputs are same. Okay. Then suppose on the top of the pushdown store is A and we are getting a symbol B. So one match we have found. So we will pop the topmost symbol to reflect this match. Okay. So that's why when Q0BA is the situation, we are remaining in the same state and we are writing null to our PDS. Okay. And similarly in the situation when top of the stack is B and we are getting A in the input, means when we are getting the different symbols whatsoever is stored on the top of the pushdown store, then we are popping it. So through these two transitions we are popping. So first symbol will be pushed by any of these two transitions, and then these four transitions will take over the charge, and by multiple application of these we will be processing our string. Okay. Actually, if our string contains equal number of A's and equal number of B's, then ultimately whatsoever A's or B's in whatsoever sequence we are pushing, ultimately those all will be popped up. Okay. And ultimately when our string finishes, we will get Z0 on the top of the pushdown store and our string has finished. So in the Q0 state, we will take a null move and we will remove this Z0 as well to signal the success. So this was the strategy which we have taken for this particular language when number of A's were equal to the number of B's. Now we want our number of A's should be greater than number of B's. So it is all the strategy will remain same. Okay, we will push first symbol whatsoever it was, whether it is A or B. Then if similar symbols we are getting, we will be pushing. When different symbols we are getting, we will be popping. So up till this point, our all transitions will be same. The only situation is because we want number of A's greater than number of B's. So ultimately when our string finishes, we should have left some number of A's on our top, on our pushdown store. So some number of A's will be there on the pushdown store. So meaning thereby the topmost symbol over our PDS will be the symbol A. So we will not get this situation. We will be in this situation Q0. Our string has finished. But here we will not get Z0. We will get what? We will get A. Okay. So what we have to do? We have to remove these A's because we want to signal the success by empty store. So we have to make our store empty. Now this is the indication whenever we are in the state Q0 and our input string has fully finished and we are having left with A's on the top, on the pushdown store. So on the top of pushdown store, we are getting A. So it is a signal of success. So now to actually accept this world, we want our PDS should be empty. So this topmost symbol A we have erased by writing null to it. Okay. Now it is not only it is not necessary that there will be only single A. There may be multiple number of A's present on the top of the pushdown. So it depends on how much number of A's are more than number of B's. Okay. So we will again use this transition. So this transition will be used multiple times, and every time we will be removing one A from the top of the pushdown store. So by applying this transition multiple number of times, we will be removing all the A's present on the pushdown store. Then we will come to the situation that we are in the state Q0. Our input has finished, so we will take only null from the input, and at the top of the pushdown store will be Z0. Because all A's from the PDS has been removed, so only Z0 will be there on the top of the pushdown store. So to make our PDS empty, we have to remove this as well. So we will write Q0 null. Okay. And we say, yes, we have made it successfully, but it is not correct. But it is not correct. Why it is not correct? Because as soon as we write Q0 null Z0 to remove Z0 from the pushdown store, then because of this transition, we can also accept null into the language. Suppose null is the word which you are testing over this PDA. Okay. So because null is the word, so we cannot take any input from the input string. Okay. So we will not get A, we will not get B in the Q0 state, and Z0, when top of the PDS is Z0, we will be having only null. So we will directly come to this transition. So delta Q0 null Z0, and then we will remove this Z0. Okay. Now Z0 is removed, so null will get accepted. While null should not be accepted in this particular language, because we want number of A's greater than number of B's. Is it okay? While in this language, when number of A's were equal to number of B's, null was accepted. But in this language, null is not accepted. So meaning thereby, we cannot do like this. Meaning thereby, whenever we are applying null and we are removing Z0, we should not be in the state Q0. We should be in some other state. So to be here in some other state, we should change this the previous transition as well. So whenever we are having the situation in the Q0 state, at the top of pushdown store, there is the symbol A. And when we have to signal success and we have to remove all the symbols stored on the PDS, then we will certainly remove this topmost symbol, but we will change the state as well. Okay. So now we will not remain to the state Q0, we will change the state. So now we are in the state Q1, and we have removed the topmost symbol A, which is present on the top of pushdown store. So this is the difference. So here we need to change the state. Okay. Now because we have come to the Q1 state, and as I have already told you, it is not necessary that there will be a single A on the PDS. There will be a single A on the PDS. Okay. So we have to remove all other A's which are present on the PDS. So now we will move further. Now we are in the state Q1. Input has finished, so null will take, and there are certain more A's present. So we'll write, we'll remove these A's as well. So we'll remain in the state Q1 and remove these A's. So now this particular transition will remove the first A present on the top of the pushdown store. Then subsequent A's present on the top of the pushdown store after the removal of this first A will be removed through this second transition. Okay. So we'll use this transition multiple number of times, because every time we will be in the state Q1, and at the top of the PDS we will be having the symbol A. So through this multiple application of this particular transition, we will remove all the A's. Now when we will remove all the A's, now we will be in the state Q1, and as all A's has been removed, so on the top of the pushdown store, the remaining symbol will be the Z0. Now we have to remove the Z0 as well, so we will remain in the same state and will remove Z0. Okay. So in this manner, through these three transitions, we will make our PDS empty. Okay. Now there is now you can see that if you are testing null here, then null will not be accepted, because in Q0 state and Z0, when Z0 is on the top of pushdown store corresponding to Q0 null Z0, there is no transition existing in our set of transitions. Okay, so that string will be rejected. So null will be rejected. So only the required string will be accepted. So here we need to change the state. Okay, so this is the solution for this particular problem. Now come on the solution of the next problem, where we want our number of A's in word W should be lesser than number of B's in our word W. Okay, so now number of A's are lesser than number of B's, it simply means that number of B's are greater than number of A's. Okay, so it is a similar problem. Only thing is, in the last problem number of A's were more. Now in this problem we want number of B's should be more. So again the strategy will be same. So up till now all the transitions will be same. So we will push first letter whatsoever it is, whether it is A or B, and then we will be pushing when we are getting the same symbols on the top of push down store and same symbol in the input. Now we will pop when PDA stop and symbol which we are getting in the input are different. So after the whole processing of the whole string, if actually the number of B's in the string are more, then we will be having some B's on the top of the push down store. So this is a situation where we have to signal success and we have to remove all the symbols present on the top of the push down store, that is all the B's, and then Z0. So simply we have to change here, in the place of A we have to write B, so Q0 null B. So through this we will be removing the first B which is present as the topmost symbol on the push down store, and then similarly we have to, now we are in the state Q1, so now in the state Q1 we will remove all other remaining B's. So rather than A, we will be writing B here. So only this simple change we have to make. So through the multiple application of this second last transition, we will remove all the B's from the top of the pushdown store. Then we will be having Z0 remaining on the top of the pushdown store. So we will also remove that Z0 and we will signal the success. So only this change has to be done when n number of A's in W is lesser than number of B's in W. So this was the solution. Now here at this point of time, I wish to explain one more thing, that up till now in all the problems, we are ultimately reaching to the symbol Z0, and that symbol Z0 only we are removing. So just if we want to write our PDA through the final states, so rather than removing Z0, simply we have to move to the final state. But here we are to remove more than one symbol, not only Z0, some other symbols are also present. So we have to remove. So that's why we were to write these three productions to ensure that all the symbols present on the top of push down store when we are to signal success are to be has been removed. Okay, so to ensure this, we have to write these three transitions. But suppose we want to write this PDA through final state. So simply, rather than writing this transition, we will be writing delta. We are in the state Q0. Our input has finished. So null we will take from there. And at the top of the pushdown stack is suppose B. So this should be equal to, we will move to a final state QF and we will leave the status of pushdown store as it is. So simply we have to change to the state QF. So now our string has already been finished and we have moved to a final state. So our string will get accepted. So rather than writing these three, we have to write only this one if we want our PDA to accept the strings through final states. So in this particular case, writing PDA through final state may be a simple one. So rather than writing these three transitions, we have to write only one. Rest all other transitions will be same. So this is also there. And whenever we are writing our PDA through the final states, we also have to, we may show that our PDA A is collection of again seven things, Q, sigma, rho, delta, Q0, Z0 and F. So what is Q here? So how many states we have used? We have used state Q0, we have used state Q0, and so up till now this is Q0 and then Q0 to QF if we are accepting it by final state. So only two states we have used. So we will be writing these two states Q0, QF. So this is the set of states. Then Q sigma, sigma will be A and B. Okay, so A and B, Q sigma. Then rho means pushdown store symbols. So what are the pushdown store symbols? Z0, A and B are pushdown store symbols. Okay, so Z0, A and B are pushdown store symbols. So Q sigma rho delta. So delta we have defined through these transitions. Okay. So delta Q sigma rho delta Q0 our start state is q0, so we have written q0 here, q0. Top initial push down stored symbol is z0, so z0 and f set of final state. So only one state is the final state, that is qf. So I will write this qf as the set of final states. So this will be my PDA. And similarly, if I am writing my PDA through empty store, so this transition will not be there, this will be the transition. So here, how many states I have used? I have used q0, I have used q1. So q0 and q1, these two states I have used. I will be writing q0, q1. Again, sigma will be same, a, b. Push down stored symbols are also same, z0, a and b, because these symbols we are pushing over the push down store. Then delta is given through this set of transitions. q0 is our start state, z0 is our initial push down stored symbol, so z0. And then, because we are not accepting our PDA, my PDA is not accepting my input string through the final states, so set of final states will be empty. So I have to write phi here. So this I will be writing when I am accepting my input strings, my PDA is accepting input strings through empty store. And if it is accepting it by final states, then set of final state will not be empty. Now we will write the solution corresponding to when number of A's in our word W is not equal to number of B's in W. We are saying that number of A's and number of B's are not equal. So meaning thereby either the number of A's are more or the number of B's are more. But they cannot be equal. They are not equal. Okay. So it converts it to the two condition, NAW greater than NBW or NAW is lesser than NBW. And we have discussed solution for both, for this and this. For both, we have already discussed the solution. So what we have to do, again the same strategy, we will follow. We will start the first letter, then we will push the letters when at top of PDS and inputs are same. And then we will pop the topmost symbol of the PDS if top of PDS and inputs are different. And by following this process, we should either be left with some number of B's on the pushdown store or some number of A's on the pushdown store. So if number of B's are more, then we will be left with the B's left over the pushdown store. If number of A's are more, then we will left with the some number of A's left over the pushdown store. So this I have already written for when number of B's are more. So similarly, so in this situation, when I am having Q0 and my input string has finished and on the top of the store, I can either get B if I am getting B, so all B's, and then Z0 has to be removed. If there are not B's, there are some A's. So I have to remove the A's. So I have to write the transition something like this, and Q1 null. Okay. So as I have written here, so similar I will write, and then in this Q1 state, rest all other A's also has to be removed. So Q1 null. So we have to simply mix whatsoever we have added for the first one and the second one. So this will be my answer. So and I will depict my PDA through this A, Q0, Q1, these two states I have used. A, B are my input. Z0, A and B are my pushdown store symbols. Transition function delta is given by all these transitions. These transitions and these transitions. And then Q0, Z0 are initial state and initial pushdown store symbol. And my set of final state is empty. So this is the solution for NA not equal to NB.